the acting commissioner of police, excellencies, members of the diplomatic corps, senior officials of government and members of the defense forces, the parade commander, officers, NCOs, senior NCOs, policemen and women on parade, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, Disambungunaka, Namaste, Assalamualaikum, and a very good morning to all of you. I'm indeed privileged to have been invited as chief guest to this memorable occasion to witness the passing out parade of 205 recruits into the Fiji Police Force. First of all, I'd like to congratulate all of you on parade this morning for a fine display. And I am honored to share this joyous occasion for you and your families who are here in numbers to celebrate your achievements. Today's passing out parade not only marks the beginning of your policing career, but the start of a lifelong journey that has a purpose, and you will soon realize that your life will be outward focused for the people that we serve. Former American President George W. Bush said, and I quote, "Any definition of a successful life must include service to others," unquote. 4 months ago, many of you marched into the Fiji Police Force Academy gates as young, carefree members of the public, having enjoyed life from a different perspective. After successfully completing your training, you will march out today as servants of the people of Fiji. You may be marching out today as the newest members of the Fiji Police Force, but your years of service will not matter in the eyes of those you serve. Because when they see the police uniform, they see an officer of the law who has been instilled with discipline, good behavior, and obedience, and one who is expected to be able to provide substance to their problems. Let me talk about the criminal landscape. Despite the ongoing public attacks against the work of the police force, we know that a lot of effort has been directed towards curbing crime, and this has resulted in a 5% reduction in overall crime from January to September this year. We've also noted a 1% reduction of serious crime recorded for the same period this year, and I commend you all for your hard work. However, I'm gravely concerned about crimes against women and children, and I'm urging you to strengthen your community policing initiatives. I urge you to get to the communities involved, from the non-government organizations, religious bodies and community groups, as these are moral crimes that needs everyone's support if we are to prevent more innocent women and children from becoming victims of domestic violence. Women have lost their lives at the hands of their partners and husbands. And any loss is not only felt by the victim's family, but by the nation. The number of women who have lost their lives as victims of domestic violence this year is disturbing. While we have mourned with the families of the 10 women who lost their lives, we owe it to them to be more vigorous in our approach and gather as much support as possible to enable our women and children to feel safe in their own homes and communities. These last few weeks have also been tragic for a number of families who have lost their loved ones in senseless motor vehicle accidents. I do not like to dwell too much on statistics, because the loss of one life is one too many. While I acknowledge the effort made to reduce the number of road fatalities and accidents, as the leading road enforcement agency, people will always be quick to point the blame on the Fiji police, because that is the perception of policing, in that we are expected to keep everyone safe. It may seem like a daunting task, but you are in an institution that people will expect more from you. So you need to be more innovative and less predictable with your strategies to curb the rising number of road accidents. I wish to assure you of government support, and I wish to remind all on parade this morning that, again, key to economic security is national security, which is why the Fiji First government has been very supportive of the work of the Fiji Police Force. Your input matters, and whether you join the CID, the traffic unit, sexual offenses, or the drugs unit, you are playing a significant role in the maintenance of law and order. This in turn will positively impact our economy, boost investor confidence, and empower all Fijians. Your restructure process was long overdue considering the demands placed on policing, and government has acknowledged this by allocating funds in the 2019-20 budget. In the next few weeks, the second phase of the Fiji Police Force's restructure process will get underway, as more than 200 special constables march in for the regularization process, and this is to boost your organization's ability to meet the increasing demands of policing. Let me also remind you that as more police officers are expected to be recruited over the next few years, opportunities will open up for you to progress your own policing careers. Now that you have confirmed your place as a member of this organization, I do hope that you will appreciate this opportunity, as there are thousands of others who are wanting to join. Before you do something that can potentially jeopardize your policing career, think about the sacrifices your families and loved ones have made for you. Today, they are here to celebrate your achievement. But rightfully, they should be applauded and commended for their support. I personally feel that the notion that we as members of the disciplined forces are making sacrifices is somewhat misguided, because the real heroes are our families. They are the unsung heroes who stand by us when we are called away for duty, often for long periods of time, to your wives and husbands who have to play the dual parental role for your children for the past 4 months, and to your parents and friends and guardians who have stood by you and supported you all throughout your lives so you can achieve your goals. As you progress in your policing career, you will realize how important their support will be. So always keep their sacrifices in mind, because when you fail, they suffer the consequences of your actions. Finally, these are my parting words. As you go out and serve your communities, remain humble. The uniform that you wear represents hope for every Fijian and visitors to our shores. With the uniform comes great responsibility. And while the going may get tough, keep in mind your mission to serve and protect. Your work as a police officer does not cease at the end of the day when you take off your uniform. You are a police officer at all times and must never turn anyone away who is in need of your assistance. You are young, and I urge you all to continue to develop yourselves through training and learning, and challenge yourselves to be better than you were yesterday. As all of the 205 of you pass out today to join your comrades on the front line, keep in mind that the life of service is meaningful and rewarding, and one of the greatest joys in life that will require your energy, time, and hard work. I wish you all the very best in your policing careers, and may the Almighty God continue to bless the Fiji Police Force and our beloved Fiji. In our level, Danabar, thank you.
He shares maternal links in Ketei Totoya Lau. He is the proud son of the late Mr. and Mrs. Nasese. He is the fourth youngest of seven siblings. He attended Valelawa Primary School.